Last week on the Dominican Republic's Next Half Revolutionary. In a shocking turn of events, Leo chooses to bow out of the competition and flee behind the trees where he will be safe from the revolution. What a weasel.
Drive me on top.
Diary. I'm so shocked that Leo left today, but really, it just made me realize that I am going to be the Dominican Republic's next top revolutionary. Sorry, I get really emotional. I know I'm going to be the next top revolutionary because not only am I a fighter, but I have feelings too. I know that there's more to just the revolution than the fighting. I'm compassionate, and I care about my family. Love, Mate.
I never really loved him anyway. And if he's not man enough to stay here and fight this revolution, then he's not the man I thought he was. And you know what? I'm here for the revolution. I'm here to fight, and I'm going to win this competition.
I'm so shocked at Leo leaving like that, just so abruptly. I'll be praying for him, and for me to becoming the winner. And that Pedrito wears those cute shorts that I love him wearing.
Mate, what are you writing about?
I just can't believe that Dad has a whole another family besides us.
What do you mean you can't believe it? That's what men do. They run away. When things get rough, they run. They're cowards.
Do you think this has anything to do with your suppressed hatred of Leo?
No. I'm so upset Leo left. I have no reason to be here anymore. He was the only reason. I don't even care about the revolution, I just wanted to be around Leo, since my husband doesn't pay attention to me. I gotta go have a pie in the oven.
Ladies, I'm Ms. J, your coach. I'd like to introduce my assistant, J. Manuel. He will be playing Trujillo today.
Hey, girls!
Ladies, to survive in the revolutionary world, one must stay true to themselves. For instance, I will stand up right now to Trujillo using my own ghetto fabulous attitude. Now, ladies, for today's lesson, I want you all to stand up to Trujillo using your own personal attitudes.
I'm not nervous for today's challenge. I've stood up to Trujillo before, and I'll do it again in a heartbeat.
Dear Diary, I'm so nervous for the challenge today because I have to stand up to Trujillo. And I know it's going to be hard because I'm a delicate soul. I feel. I want to help with the revolution, but I want to help my family at the same time. The only reason I am here is because I love my daughter Jackie. And because I thought my husband was really hot and he was a part of the revolution, so I joined that reason. But really, I love Jackie. Everything I do is for my daughter. I love Jackie more than life itself. Jackie, do you hear me? Mama loves you, Jackie!
Dear Diary, let me tell you about all the terrible things Trujillo has done to our nation. Love, Mate.
I'm so nervous for today's challenge. Not only am I nervous for today's challenge, but I'm also nervous to be leaving my Pedrito for more than an hour. How will I handle this?
I miss today's challenge because I don't really care about the revolution. And furthermore, those cookies weren't going to bake themselves.
Dear Diary, for our photo shoots this week, it's our job to portray ourselves being strong through the terrible situations Trujillo has caused. For instance, my photo shoot is all about all the people Trujillo has killed. And it's my job to be the strong one who lives, to keep the fight going on. I hope I can portray it well. Love, Mate. Minerva's been so mean lately.
I know.
I'm Minerva.
I've got some serious liberty shoved up my...
For my photo shoot, I'm going to be the only girl who refuses to sleep with Trujillo. And I think I should be able to do pretty well at this shoot since I've personally experienced this situation.
I will be the person portraying all of the homeless people because of Trujillo, but I will be the one who stood up to keep my land.
I missed today's photo shoot because I don't really care about the revolution. And furthermore, that lemon bundt cake wasn't going to cook itself.
Fine. Come on, show me some magic, girl. Come on, you can do it. Oh my god, yeah, love that pose. Love it, girl, love it. Come on, work it. Lovely, lovely. Come on, keep it, girl. Come on, you can do it. Oh my god, that is so amazing. Tria, this is your time to shine. Give me some magic. Oh my god, this is amazing. I love it. Oh my gosh. Oh, magic. You are killing me, girl.
You know what? The elimination really doesn't even matter to me because I know that whether or not I win this competition, I'm the only true revolutionary here.
Welcome, ladies, to panel tonight. This week was all about being true to yourself and rising up from conditions that were bad in order to succeed in this revolution. Let's see how you did tonight. I'd like to introduce you to our panel of judges. On my left, we have Janice Dickinson, the first revolutionary in the world.
Hey, ladies.
And on my right, we have Jay Manuel, the director of your photo shoot yesterday.
Hey, ladies.
Unfortunately, our other two judges, Nigel Barker and Ms. Jay, cannot be here with us tonight. Ms. Jay was shot in the head by one of Trujillo's men, and Nigel died in a kind of shady car accident up in the mountains this past week. He should learn to drive better. Now let's get started. Mate, would you please step forward? Let's take a look at your best photo this week.
Ooh, work it, girl!
Mate, this photo's really great for one main reason. I like the feeling in the picture. I can tell that you care about the revolution not only in your head, but also in your heart. It's good. I like the emotion in your eyes. What do you think, Jay?
Yes.
Thank you, Mate. Well, Minerva, please step forward. Minerva, let's take a look at your best photo. Your best photo this week. Minerva, I have one word for you, girl. Yes.
Girl, this picture is smoking hot. You look like a fierce bitch.
What do you think, Jay?
It's great.
Thank you. Well, Katria, please step forward. Let's take a look at your best photo.
Katria, you have a beautiful face, but this picture just falls flat for me.
Katria, what I like most about you is your spirituality and your ability to pray. But this week, when you pray, it's just kind of like, I want to see you be more like, do you get what I'm saying? Do you see that difference? It's subtle, I know. Jay, what do you think?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Patria. Well, Day-Day, please step forward. Now, Day-Day, at this time, normally I would say, let's look at your best photo this week. But you don't have a photo this week, Day-Day. You said there was something more important than the revolution that you needed to attend to.
Day-Day, this is so disappointing. In the revolutionary world, you cannot just pass up an opportunity to make yourself heard. That's just not going to cut it in this competition or in the real world.
Day-Day, I'm disappointed in you. Mama Tyra is disappointed in you. I had hopes for you. I saw potential in you. It was thrown away. What do you think, Jay?
Mm-hmm.
Well, Day-Day, you were returned to where you were. We have a lot of talking to do, some important decisions to make. Your girls may exit first. We have some decisions to make. Our first girl to talk about, Minerva.
Minerva is a strong girl. She is a good revolutionary.
I thought this was a really great week for Minerva. She looked strong. She had passion in her eyes.
She believes in this cause.
And it's L-O-V-E, this girl.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think, Jay? Okay. Our next girl. Mate.
No, Mate was pretty strong this week, not as strong as her sister Minerva, but it's definitely there.
I really think Mate has a lot of potential. I think she may have started out in this competition for the wrong reasons, but as she keeps going, I think her love for the revolution and her desire to make this world a better place is really what is keeping her.
Mm-hmm.
She's grown a lot through this competition, and I think she's still growing.
Mm-hmm.
You think this, Jay?
Mm-hmm.
Our next girl, Petria. This was kind of a rough week for Petria, I thought.
Mm-hmm.
The spark that she used to have, that we fell in love with, has kind of subsided.
Not her best week, but
there's something about her. I think she still has a little more left in her that she wants to show us. What do you think, Jay?
Mm-hmm.
And finally, Day-Day.
Oh, this girl, I can't believe her this week. So unprofessional.
Well, I don't understand why she wouldn't come to her photo shoot.
She needs to demand some more respect for herself and her country.
I agree. Mm. Day-Day, you said it. She needs some more respect. R-E-S-P-E-C-T, find out what it means to me. R-E-S-P-E-C-T, take care of T-C-B. Alright, I think we have reached a decision. Welcome, ladies. There are 4 strong revolutionaries in front of me, but only 3 of you can continue in the hopes of becoming the Dominican Republic's next half revolutionary. The first name I'm going to call is Minerva. Congratulations, Minerva. You're still in the running towards becoming Dominican Republic's next half revolutionary. The next person I'm going to call is someone whom the judges have seen a lot of growth in this week. She is someone who entered this competition weak as kind of a lamb following the herd. But very recently, we've seen that she is a tiger all on her own. Next I'm going to call is Mate. Congratulations, Mate. You're still in the running in the hopes of becoming the Dominican Republic's next top revolutionary. Will Petria and Day-Day please step forward? You both are in the bottom two for very different reasons. Petria, you are someone who started this competition so strong, with such a fire in her eyes. But this week, we saw that fire was starting to be extinguished. And we are a little worried that your passion for this competition is running out. Day-Day, on the other hand, well, Day-Day, you don't even have the fire enough to even show up for the challenge or for the photo. How are we supposed to believe that you still have the desire to help this country? So who goes? The girl whose fire is fading? Or the girl whose fire was perhaps never lit. Petria, I don't think your fire's going out just yet. Congratulations, you're still in the hopes of becoming the Dominican Republic's next half revolutionary. Day-Day, I want you to look at this not as a loss, but as an opportunity to encourage yourself to keep doing better, that you can succeed. I believe in you, Day-Day.
I don't even care, Tyra. I never want to be part of this stupid competition anyway, and I have some really good blueberry muffins in the oven.
Day-Day, I'm so upset
and hurt to see this blatant disregard for this competition. I know, deep down, you care about this competition. You care about the revolution. You're just afraid. Don't you realize? Poverty passes away, but what does not pass away is dishonesty. Don't you see it? This is what our whole teacher's about this week. Being true to yourself. You have to rise above the conditions that you were given, and you have to do your best to succeed in everything you can do. Don't you get it, Dana? When my mama yells at me like this, that's because she loves me. Don't you see, Dana? I love you. I want the best for you and for your family and for your mean husband. I'm here for you, girl. Get out of here.
Ugh, going home. Finally. Finish that beef stroganoff I started. You know what? You haven't even seen the end of dating. When you need life insurance, you'll be crawling right back to me. I'm not surprised Day Day got eliminated. She couldn't even show up to the challenge. I'm surprised she even made it this far.
I feel so bad for Monte. She's always crying. It's been so hard on her. I'll pray for her.
Gonna do with all that junk inside the trunk.
I'm gonna get you more of this one. I cannot handle Worker Diary anymore. Her stupid brown face keeps distracting us. She's dumb. I don't even think she can read. And furthermore, all she feeds us is rice. Dang it!